The views and opinions of this broadcast do not reflect the views and opinions of Armed Media, UNU Productions and its affiliates. Enjoy the show.
Chair recognizes the gentleman from South Carolina, Mr. Gowdy, for 5 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. The Russia investigation has been going on for almost 2 years now. Special counsel's investigation has been going on for over a year now. For most Americans, it's important to know what Russia did to our country in 2016 and with whom, if anyone, they did it. When a foreign state interferes with our democratic electoral process, it should be chance of a lifetime for a law enforcement agent to investigate that, except apparently the one that was actually picked to investigate it. That was Peter Strzok. FBI agent Peter Strzok was picked to lead the FBI's investigation into what Russia did in July of 2016. It was a counterintelligence investigation begun in late July 2016, and he was leading it. And at about the exact same time he was picked to lead it, this dispassionate and fair FBI agent was calling Trump a disaster, destabilizing for the country. I'll leave out all the F adjectives he used to describe that. I'll just go with disaster and destabilizing. Same time, his FBI lawyer girlfriend, Lisa Page, was telling him he was meant to protect the country. This neutral, dispassionate FBI agent said, I can protect the country at many levels. Same time, Peter Strzok, who was picked to objectively, fairly, neutrally look into the Russia investigation, was talking about an insurance policy with Andy McCabe and Lisa Page in the event Donald Trump became the president. All of this was happening at the same time Peter Strzok said he could smell the Trump support in Southern Virginia. All of this was at the same time that this FBI agent said a Trump presidency would be effing terrifying and that it will never happen. No, no, we'll stop it. So while investigating Russia and their attempt to subvert our democracy may have been important to the rest of the country, it wasn't all that important to about a half dozen FBI agents and lawyers who were assigned to the case. For them, it was an investigation to stop Donald Trump, which then brings us to May of 2017 and the appointment of special counsel, where we find Peter Strzok again, this same supposed to be dispassionate, neutral, fair FBI agent. You would think he'd be really excited about investigating what a foreign power tried to do to this country, but you would be wrong again for Peter Strzok at precisely the same time that Bob Mueller was appointed, precisely the same time. Peter Strzok was talking about his unfinished business and how he needed to fix and finish it so Donald Trump did not become president. He was talking about impeachment within 3 days of special counsel Mueller being appointed. 3 days. That's even quicker than MSNBC and the Democrats were talking about impeaching him. Within 3 days, the lead FBI agent is talking about impeaching the president. So this is where we are. We're 2 years into this investigation. We're a year and a half into the presidency. We're over a year in the special counsel. You have a counterintelligence investigation that's become public. You have a criminal investigation that's become political. You have more bias than I have ever seen manifest in a law enforcement officer in the 20 years I used to do it for a living. And four other DOJ employees who had manifest animus towards the person they were supposed to be neutrally and detachedly investigating. Democrats are using this investigation as a presumption of guilt, which I find astonishing. And in the long run, for the health of this republic, I would encourage them to go back to the presumption of innocence that we used to hold sacred. There's a presumption of guilt. There's a desire by Democrat senators to fundraise off of your investigation. More than 60 Democrats have already voted to proceed with impeachment before Bob Mueller has found a single solitary damn thing. More than 60 have voted to move forward with impeachment, and he hasn't presented his first finding. So I'm going to say this to you, Mr. Ray, Mr. Rosenstein. I realize that neither one of you were there when this happened, but you're both there now. Russia attacked this country. They should be the target, but Russia isn't being hurt by this investigation right now. We are. This country is being hurt by it. We are being divided. We've seen the bias. We need to see the evidence. If you have evidence of wrongdoing by any member of the Trump campaign, present it to the damn grand jury. If you have evidence that this president acted inappropriately, present it to the American people. There's an old saying that justice delayed is justice denied. I think right now all of us are being denied. Whatever you got, finish it the hell up, because this country is being torn apart. I would yield back, Mr. Chairman.
Either the witnesses care to respond to the...
Well, I would simply respond, Ms. Gowdy. I certainly share your views about those text messages. And nobody is more offended than I about what's reflected in those messages. With regard to the investigation, I've heard suggestions that we should just close the investigation. I think the best thing we can do is finish it appropriately and reach a conclusion. And I certainly agree with you, sir, that people should not jump to conclusions without seeing the evidence. I've been the victim of fake news attacks myself, so I'm sympathetic. I agree with you, sir, that there's been no allegation made by the Department of Justice or the special counsel other than what's reflected in those documents that are filed publicly, the charged folks. And nobody should draw any conclusions beyond those charges.
Tax the rich, feed the poor, tell
I can hear you.
What the hell you can hear?
I can't hear.
Alright, folks, welcome to Pod Talk. I'm Jimmy Bell.
I'm Paul Daniels.
And I'm Jeremy Gibbs. And over here to my left, the sound guy.
Tonight, you can call in at 1-800-508-5431. Again, that's 1-800-508-5431.
All right, well, let's blab about what we just heard. Partially?
You didn't hear Rosenstein's thing.
No, it cut there. Off at Rosenstein, but I've seen bits and pieces of this video.
Otherwise, I'd have been echoing him when I come in. I had to shut it off before.
That's
that.
Right. I just lost the feed towards
Rosenstein
the end.
Rosenstein did nothing but deny everything that Trey Gowdy said.
Well, yeah.
And Trey Gowdy is, he's a dog with a bow, man.
They've been on this for over a year. They've been asking for over a year, and Rosenstein won't get
just
the information.
Just stonewalls and stonewalls and stonewalls.
He was passing the buck saying, and he's not in charge of that. There's other people that redact it. He's just passing the buck. He's the second in charge, but he's not in charge.
He's not.
You know what I mean? He's not accountable.
Yes. Yeah. No accountability. Thank you.
Yeah, I gotta say though that none of this is going to come out. I don't see any of it coming out because they're trying to cover it up and they're waiting something out. If they weren't trying to cover something up or hide something in the background, the information would already be released.
Exactly. If they had nothing to hide, they'd throw it out there and say, see?
Yeah. But also, at the same time, I think Trey Gowdy, as good intentions as he seems to be, sometimes I think he's part of the process of holding this up.
Do you really think that?
No, not at all. He didn't try holding up Benghazi.
Well,
that was
I think that's the reason he's wanting to back out.
Adam Schiff.
But not run for
re-election.
Yeah.
Adam Schiff tried to shove this into the
tank.
No.
But we're trying to get back. Trey Gowdy is not running for re-election because
yes.
he may be part of the swamp.
No, he said he was tired of the swamp.
Then you stay there and fight.
Well, that's what I don't get.
Yeah.
He just
said he
out.
Was going to go back
that's
to
what
doing
said.
What he does best, which was
right.
being a prosecutor.
Exactly.
If
which he should be doing in there, because
can we let Jeremy finish a sentence?
No, because I got a fucking idea.
Get it out.
No, I don't remember.
No, you said he's not running for re-election because of.
Uh oh.
All right.
Crickets.
Yes, where's your sound effects there?
Yeah, we usually don't do sound effects on this show, but...
That's all right.
Trey Gowdy, he says he's backing out, not going to run for re-election, because he's going to go back to being a prosecutor or something to that effect.
Yeah.
But if that is the case, then he should be the one prosecuting all these crimes that's going on with the Russia investigation.
Well, but isn't that a special counsel that's prosecuting? It's not just a regular,
Yeah, Robert Mueller, who's in cahoots with Hillary Clinton, in cahoots with Harry Reid, in cahoots with Obama, in cahoots with Comey. Who's he not in cahoots with? Well, he's got a special interest in making the president look bad.
Yeah, absolutely. I agree with that. If Trey Gowdy wants to go somewhere where he can help and he doesn't want to be, go for a federal judgeship.
Yeah.
Right, that would make sense.
You know, go on the Sixth Circuit or something like that.
No, the Ninth.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, he would never, ever get on the Ninth. It would be funny as hell, though.
No, like I said, it doesn't matter. If there's an opening, Trump can fill it.
That's true.
Well, oh my God, throwing Trey there's Gowdy. Rumor that... Judge, I believe Andrew Napolitano, however you pronounce his name, is going to be one of Trump's nominations.
Nah, for the Supreme Court, you mean?
Maybe.
No, I don't think so. He's for analyzing on TV.
Yeah, he's a good analyst and stuff, and he is a constitutionalist.
No, I don't think so. A lot of stuff I don't agree with.
Yeah,
exactly.
No, I definitely agree with you on
It'd
that.
Be a swing like Kennedy.
Yes. Yep. Yeah. Or what's his name? Roberts.
Yeah.
Roberts.
John Roberts.
What a fucking disappointment he turned out to be, huh? What a fucking disappointment.
But yeah, I think these guys, you know, I think a lot of these guys who are testifying about this Russia investigation are just out there delaying it. It's they know way more than they are telling us, and they're not going to let it out. Just like
it's not
Jeff Sessions.
There is no conspiracy.
No. He's talking about the other side.
Just like Jeff Sessions, he's a part of the Trump administration, and I honestly believe the reason this Russia investigation is getting stalled is partly because of him as well, because I think he wants to wait out the statute of limitations so Clinton cannot be prosecuted.
Yeah, he's part of the swamp.
That's like 7 years.
I agree.
Be that long. This ain't going to drag out 7 years. I know that for a fact.
Well, they're certainly going to try it because they're probably expecting Trump to get reelected. So, you know, that would give them plenty of time to drag it out.
Yeah.
Well, they want to drag it out to 2020 and make something out of it, which they're going to lose. They're idiots.
Well, the longer they stick on these issues, is the
it's
worse they're going to look.
It's 2 years later since he got elected. You know what I mean? Almost 2 years later, and they still don't have a plan. They're idiots.
They don't have a plan. They don't have any evidence against him either. They have nothing. Absolutely nothing except bullshit and rhetoric, and it's going to get them nowhere except out of office.
Right. Like I said, I hope Nancy Pelosi stays in line. I want to hear from Maxine Waters. This is what's going to make Trump get in.
It's Maxine Waters, she's had assault charges pressed against her yesterday, I believe this was.
Really?
They're talking about censoring her, or censure. Whatever.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Censure.
Censure.
Yeah. It's like...
They want to...
It's almost like...
a pink slip or something.
Yes,
you know
exactly.
Something on your record.
When she, but more or less, incited violence and riots against the Trump and his administration, that was it. She broke the law right there, and to stop her, even the Democrats are pushing...
Yeah, even
censure.
Pelosi. Even Pelosi said it was out of line, and Pelosi...
Yeah.
Is as fucking far left as it gets.
But the problem is the damage is already done. Everybody's already heard her say this shit. And those who listen to it will probably act on it.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Well, there's somebody out there right now that is definitely planning on acting on that. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. Well, you saw what happened to the Red Hen. One of their owners had to resign.
Yeah, from, she resigned from, not like the Chamber of Commerce, but it was something like that, too. Another
Something similar, yes.
Small Business Association.
Yeah, something like that, exactly. Yep.
And they had somebody, a Trump supporter, throw chicken shit at the building. He was arrested.
That's good.
Yeah, but he's going to be arrested. He's released, 25 minutes later. He goes about his business.
Yeah, mm-hmm. They get it for a nuisance.
And do you know what the funny thing is? Nobody asked the question, you know, when they were talking about Sarah Huckabee, right? Well, you know, people mm-hmm. have the right to, you know, not serve people and shit, right? Suddenly, they have that right. What if it was a gay person?
Right.
Oh, yeah, you'd have been sued and run out of business for that.
Exactly.
That's why they got this Mystic, I keep wanting to call it Mystic Pizza in Indiana. This was a few years ago. They got run out of business because they refused to cater a gay wedding.
I'll tell you what, what's
then Melissa's Cakes
got a lawsuit.
Melissa,
you know, for discrimination.
Melissa's Cakes, which this was also around the same time at the pizza place, they got sued to the point to where they couldn't afford to run their business anymore.
Yeah, they got hit for like $160,000.
They lost everything.
Yep.
When, you know, if a gay person, or I'm sorry, a liberal, refuses to serve somebody like Sarah Huckabee Sanders, oh my God, it's the greatest thing in the world, but by God, if you refuse to cater a gay wedding or bake a gay cake, oh my God, we're going to run you out of business and sue you.
Well, when it's a liberal, it's truth against power, but when it's a Republican, it's bigotry.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And effectively, there's no other way to say it.
Bunch of political hypocrites.
Well, yeah. Well, in their eyes, they hold the high ground. As long as it's coming out of their mouth, it has merit. If it's coming out of a conservative's mouth, it's hate speech.
They're always going to see it that way. And that's you got Republicans, senators, and everything else saying that a civil war is coming. Yeah. Whether it be in the form of actual fighting or whatnot, but they say it's coming. There are even places that are laying out maps, what states will go where, and all this.
Yeah, we're the safe place to go if you're a Republican. You know, if you're a conservative,
one of them
place where you can find like-minded people.
Yeah, one of those is Ohio.
Really.
Yes.
I would imagine New Hampshire would be on that list. We got really fucking left.
Trying to find the map I saw earlier and all. I'll tell you as soon as I find it. But yeah, I do believe New Hampshire's in there.
Yeah. We're a constitutional New Hampshire, Ohio, state.
Basically all the northern states.
Well, not the rest of New England. I'll tell you that right now. Fucking Connecticut, Massachusetts, Rhode Island. It's just a fucking den of fucking debauchery. And that's what it is. It's sanctuary fucking cities. It's fucking welfare for anyone that just shows up at the door.
Oh.
All the southern New England states.
Right.
Vermont, they're another one. I wouldn't consider them a southern New England state, but it's basically New Hampshire and Maine. That have some semblance of reality.
No, Maine copies everything Mass does.
Right to a certain extent.
They do, except for their concealed carry.
Right, they have, exactly.
That's about the only thing that's different.
Yeah, I guess you're right on that. I guess you are kind of right. Because it's a major welfare state.
Oh, 8.5% service tax or state tax.
Yeah, sales tax is like, yeah. And the income tax is like 6.5.
I don't know.
In Mass, it's only 5. Well, and you make good money in Mass.
For state tax.
Is it in Mass?
Yeah.
Is it really?
Deval upped it from 5 to 6.
Tax all Deval.
Yeah, exactly.
Thank God that
Democrat that doesn't want to raise your taxes.
Yeah. What a douchebag. Thank God.
That's what he ran on, not raising your taxes.
Yeah. Right.
Well, he became a nobody.
Exactly.
This map here basically says it'll be an east versus west kind of deal.
I don't believe east versus west because the two coasts, I think it's going to be coast, and then middle America.
Yeah,
I kind of believe that too. But
The left and left coast and
Middle America.
Yeah, Middle America is going to be fighting the fucking elites on either seaboard.
Out of the country, there was a term for it. I can't think of it.
Yeah, no, not a big deal.
No.
We as people that believe in freedom actually have to stand up. I mean, we're at the breaking point right now. You're seeing a duly elected president being fucking persecuted.
Right,
it's like a witch.
His cabinet's being persecuted. Everything about him is just...
And now the fucking, what's-his-face is retiring from the Supreme Court.
Kennedy.
Yeah. Chuck Schumer and all them.
Come on.
No matter who
it is.
No matter who it is.
Don't vote for him.
Yeah. What the hell is that?
What kind
of strategy is that?
We still got a 51. No, we don't either. John McCain ain't going to come on.
Not McCain.
Yeah, fuck
he should
McCain.
Give him a seat. That's just disgusting the way he's doing this. It's 50-49 is basically what it is.
Yeah, but we got the vice president as the fucking swing vote.
Well, there ain't no tie because John McCain ain't going to be there.
If there is a tie...
He can't vote when the hospital...
No, but I'm just saying, if there is a tie... Oh, yeah, no, they can vote from a state.
No, he can't. But
he can't?
Yeah, but he said he couldn't. Yeah. He's got to be there to vote.
Watching that big bulge in his head as he runs down onto the floor and puts the thumbs down.
He's a fucking asshole.
That fucking douchebag. I can hardly wait till he dies.
Me neither.
I really hate to say it.
The same one I wanted to see die quick was Ted Kennedy.
Oh,
this
I get this.
The next Democrat I want to see die quick.
Yeah, and he's actually he's got an R in front of his fucking name.
Yeah, I know. Oh, yeah, that's why he is a Republican, he thinks.
Yeah, I just don't see... I don't see this carrying on a whole lot longer before somebody cracks and fires the first shot.
Do you know what? Eventually, Trump's going to put up a Supreme Court nominee, and they're going to have to accept it eventually. They have to.
Yeah, but they can delay it and delay it and delay it.
Well, they're going to delay it till after the election, which is a good thing, because we got a red wave going. They don't have a blue wave.
And
like
go ahead.
Talking about.
Because you got an empty seat in the Supreme Court, right? That's a non-vote.
Right, it's 4-4 right now.
Right. So if he's gone, he's usually sides with the Democrats anyways.
Mm-hmm.
So fuck it. He's gone. He's got no vote. That's a yes vote.
No, he sided with the Republicans, and he wrote the, you know how at the end somebody writes a...
Yeah.
The decision
or whatever. Well, he did, and that's the one I can't remember. He didn't do the union. That was Alito. I can't think of remember what Kennedy did. And it's just recently. We're talking within a week.
Well, I know what you're talking
about. USA Today posted an article. And I'm not going to click on this and try to read it. But it more or less it says almost a third of U.S. voters think a second civil war is on its way.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah, I agree too.
Eventually, we have to do something if we want to save the republic.
I'm honestly shocked that at this point in Trump's presidency, he has not cracked down.
How can he? Because then it'd look like the dictator, Nazi.
Exactly. I think that's part of the reason, but I am surprised he's been able to keep his cool and not crack down.
He can't crack down because that'd be the worst thing to do. He'd lose the base.
I don't know. I think a large amount of the base would side with him.
No, when it gets into a world war, a civil war, then he might crack down. But he can't do it now.
No, right now would be an inappropriate time to do so, but...
Like I said, when we're fighting each other, that's when he can crack down and say, this is it.
The preemptive strike would not work well here.
Right.
I agree with that.
At some point or another, it's going to happen.
Something's going to happen. happen.
People got to be super, super pissed, though.
Well, you know what it is? Soros is paying all these left-wing radicals. Yep. You know what I mean? They're all getting...
Well, yeah, he's funding a lot of these left-wing groups.
Back in the 60s, you did it because you had your heart into it. Not because it was somebody filling your wallet.
Yeah, they pick it's you totally up in a bus. Different. They fucking shuttle you there. They give you a paycheck.
Their heart's not into it. You can just back
them
people
down. They don't
even
know what the fuck they're protesting.
None of them do.
They're idiots.
They've been indoctrinated. None of them are educated.
They're a bunch of fucking college morons.
Yeah, the goons. They have no fucking idea. The flunking college.
No, they... Well, actually, they're probably getting a B or an A. In
for
fucking
doing it.
In fucking liberal arts.
Yeah, we'll give you extracurricular.
Yeah, you'll get
extra
points.
Where does a liberal arts degree actually get you? Nowhere.
Nothing. Zero, zilch, nothing. Nothing. The only thing you can get out of that is teaching the same shit you were taught to somebody else. That's it. You're a teacher or nothing. And by you're a teacher or nothing... If you're a teacher of liberal arts, you are nothing. You are nothing. You're a fucking empty suit.
Yeah, mostly. Most of the politicians are empty suits. Because if any of them were doing their jobs halfway right, we wouldn't be going through this in the first place. It's bad.
Do you know what it is? Politicians have decided that they no longer work for us. We work for them.
Well, yeah, it's all about who has the money and who has the power. It's never going to be about us. The only way it'll be about us is if we take back the government, which would require civil war.
Yes. Well, when you can vote yourself a pay raise, the people have lost all control.
Control, because we can't stop it.
We can't stop it. It's not up to us.
Now
it's
they want
to
gradually raise the gas tax during periodically, automatically. Like nobody votes on it; it just automatically.
It just
goes
happens
up
after 3 years or whatever.
It automatically goes up. That's just bullshit. It
goes up 2% every 3 years or whatever.
2%? You wish it was 2%.
Well, I'm just throwing a number.
It's probably more like 10% a year.
But the but the cost of living will go up 3%, but the tax will go up 7%.
Right. In other words,
you're on a treadmill running at the carrot, and the carrot, you can never catch it. It's like
you can almost touch. You can almost just almost
working
touch it. And
jobs,
it's just,
and you still can't get
it. It's almost there. Yeah, exactly. And you think, well, if I work another job, I'll catch it. And no. They move the carrot further out.
Right, they
they keep you thinking you're going to get it, but you won't. It'll never happen. It's never going to happen.
But they tell you the American dream and stuff, right? And they have no fucking idea what it takes to actually run a household and shit. Because they live in D.C., they live in the Beltway... They only converse with their own kind and fucking lobbyists and shit like that. Those that can ingratiate themselves upon them. And they hold court. And people come and they bring their burnt fucking offerings to these assholes.
Right.
You talking about the old Jesus at the church?
I was making a comparison.
Temple,
I was making a comparison, but it's the same idea. They're no longer civil servants. They're supposed to be people like
that
they come
serve
home.
Their constituents, and they don't anymore.
Yeah, they want to be fucking gods.
They serve whoever pays them money.
Yeah, but
that's
they,
how fucking people like John McCain and Maxine Waters become millionaires when they're only making $250,000 a year.
Yeah, but they're shoving it up your ass, right? And they still want you to worship them.
Right.
It's
like I said,
no.
they're screwing us.
But if you talk down to them, I'm a senator. Here's an example, just to throw this out, right? When they talk to each other, the distinguished gentleman from Arizona.
I heard about that today. That's the only way you can. You can't call him by name and you can't get personal.
Yeah.
That was for a reason. That's no, part
you
of
should
the
be
rule.
Able to say, Senator John McCain.
No, they can't.
Why?
They're
why
saying, just... The gentleman from Arizona, that's... It's a stupid idea, but it makes sense. It did.
Distinguished gentleman.
Whatever.
Or
the
like
gentlewoman
you
from
or you
California
to,
is what they call or, Maxine
or,
Waters.
Right. Or you have to call a judge, Your Honor. Who the fuck are you?
You're switching things now.
No, but I'm just saying it's the title.
No.
It's to impose a fucking...
It's nothing to do with the Senate.
It's to impose a thought upon a person
no,
that they are better than
you.
You
got it all fucked up.
No, I'm totally right.
So you're not personal is what the whole idea is about. That's why you say the gentleman from South Carolina, because there's a lot of gentlemen from South Carolina. It could be anybody. You're not being personal.
Well, you don't have to say the dickhead. But you
right, like I said,
Senator,
if you said
you
Senator so-and-so, then everybody's going
to
hate him.
Why? That's their title.
Like I said, it's got something to do with personal.
You mean
personal
right?
attacks.
All right, well, let me
okay?
ask you something.
That's
Jim.
All I got
let
out
me
of
ask
it
you
today.
Something,
personal
Jim.
Attacks.
Why do you have to call a judge Your Honor?
Because they supposedly, once they get their judgeship, they deserve that honor. Just like a doctor
do
does when they get their doctor. You're supposed to call them
yeah,
doctor.
Yeah, they're a doctor.
And I refuse to call Dr. Marielle McKinley doctor.
Yeah, well. No, but I'm saying Your Honor, Jimmy, is like that you're subservient to that person.
Right, because he's supposedly the mediator. He's the one that's in charge of everything, which he is. He's in charge of the courthouse.
Yeah, then why can't you just say, judge, not Your Honor? What makes them honorable? What?
Well, if you go say no judge, they might take that as personal, bully, you know what I mean? But then you say no, Your Honor. It's different.
Do you know what? That actually kind of made some sense. I just don't like the idea where
it's your first impressions. Most of the time, first time you're seeing the judge. Most
but what
of
do
the
they
time.
Call you?
Then when you do repeat,
what do they call you? The defendant.
Right.
Can we go to commercial break? I need a new beer.
Name. I've never heard that before.
No, you can go. You can go get a beer. Me and Jimmy will just argue for a minute.
Well, that's what you've been doing for about 10 minutes, and I'm listening yeah. to it. It's kind of cool.
As long as you're not screaming.
Yet.
Right. Take a hit off of that joint. Jeremy. You'll feel better.
We'll smoke this joint and choke it up.
Oh, for fuck's sake. Jimmy.
Yes?
Where did this conversation start?
I don't remember.
I know.
What are we talking about?
Oh, Trey Gowdy.
Oh, well,
that's how it actually started.
In the clip, yeah.
Yeah. We have a second clip, don't we?
Yes, we do. We're about beyond the half hour. We could probably play
all right,
it
that's
now.
Why I just wanted to make sure it's ready to rock.
It is, but it's 7 minutes. I'm going to wait for Jeremy to get back, and we'll play it. Anyways, what do we want to talk about? How's the wife treating you?
Ashley's a cunt.
You're back on Facebook.
Yes, I went back on Facebook.
Tell the
I
audience
broke.
Where they can get a hold of you.
On Facebook, Paul Daniels. They can find me on Paw Talk.
Yep.
P.O.T.
No, it's T underscore, but anyways. Once you do the
back.
P period and the O period, it pops up. It says Paw Talk with Jim Bell and Paul Daniels.
And we got to add Jeremy Gibson to that, you know.
Well, we got to come up with another page or something. I just can't change the page.
Just change the title.
Well, can you?
Yeah, I'm sure you can.
I don't know. I'm not Facebook savvy. As a matter of fact, I don't like Mark Zuckerberg. I think he's a fucking two-faced cocksucker.
Yeah, everyone does. We all do, Jim.
You know what I mean? So, I'm not... If they come up with something besides Facebook, I'd switch.
Well, Donald said there's a place...
Yeah,
Jeremy
but not enough people
knows.
Are switching over.
Yeah, I know.
Jeremy don't know
you
shit.
You're going to be the only one then?
What's that conservative Facebook page that Coots keeps talking about?
that Coots keeps talking about?
Yeah.
Well, shit, there's a ton of them. There's Donald's like, page, Trump 2020.
No. It's like Facebook.
But it's a different company.
Oh, Infinity SN, probably.
Infinity XN?
SN.
SN? See, I don't like Xfinity. That's got to do with...
No, it's Infinity SN.
Infinity, not X.
What is Donald it? Says Infinity sucks.
Oh, yay.
N is an IN?
Yeah, Infinity.
Okay. Yes.
Like it never ends.
All right.
Yeah. Infinity.
Still think sounds like too much like Xfinity.
Yeah, well. Anyways, Donald says it sucks.
Yeah, well, Donald's pretty much right. I have an account on there, and I don't even use it.
Yeah, why bother?
Well, there's not enough people. Like I said, that's what Zuckerberg's hoping on. Nobody's going to switch over until a lot of people switch over. You know what I mean?
Right.
How do we do that? That's the next step. That's the next step in technology.
How
do we cross over?
Like MySpace was the first one.
Right.
And then Facebook.
Right.
Yeah, MySpace kind of disappeared.
Facebook, you know what I mean?
Kind of disappeared? It's like America Online. It's gone.
Yeah, right now that Infinity SN's running on beta, so.
Yeah. Yeah, like the beta fucking VCR.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Oh, that's the next step in technology. No, it's not. Why? Because everyone has this, and they're not going to switch. VHS sucked next to beta
right.
for picture quality, but nobody switched to it.
Donald says, MySpace is a ghetto.
It is. It's a fucking wasteland.
It used to be pretty awesome. You could get on there and play music and chit-chat with your friends and shit. Now it's like dead space. Pretty much what a lot of these social media sites are trying to do. Facebook, really. Facebook especially. It's creating a monopoly. Because create that monopoly, they have that control. They decide what you see. They decide what you hear.
They're giving it to the government, their control. That's what I don't like about it. Who are they to go in cahoots with the government and start giving...
Yeah, who are they to tell us what we can or can't say, can or can't hear, can or can't see?
Ah, they're the administrators of it.
Yeah, they think they know what's best for 300 and some odd million people. I don't fucking think so.
Well, actually, on Facebook, it's like 1.2 billion or something like that that's on Facebook.
Out of how many in the country? I mean, the world?
7 and something billion.
Yeah. Facebook, I guess, finally got back with Donald on his old account. They deleted that account.
Oh, they did?
Yeah.
Any reason?
I don't know. I'll wait and see if Donald types back to me, but... Yeah, they'll eventually track down the counties on now and ban it, too.
I had to start a new account today.
That's what they do to Dave Coots. You know, they don't like conservatives, so anybody they can silence and do it with ease, they're going to do it.
And the thing is, Dave's hardcore. He really is.
Yeah. He's hardcore to the point that it is sometimes comical.
Yeah, right. Absolutely.
Hey, you know what?
We need that voice.
Yeah, you're right. You're absolutely right. We need that voice. If we lose people like Dave or like ourselves, who do we have? Nobody.
That's what I'm saying. Now,
yeah, nobody.
Nobody's going to stand up for us. But us.
Donald's got shut off. You know what I mean? That's just two. What? How many people we know?
And I'm not even that radical.
You know what I mean? So bring that out nationwide. You know, that's a lot of people they're throwing
up. What? I honestly think it wasn't about my political points of view. I honestly think it was about, because I made fun of retarded people and stuff like that. I think it was more about that because I'm not that radical in my political points of view. I think it was more about, you know, because I was posting pictures, you know, of retarded kids and...
What?
For yucks, for jokes.
Well, I had a friend of mine. He posted over the course of like a year or so, he posted like 30 different pictures of the rebel flag, and they banned his account permanently for that.
There you go. There you go. Look, it's either all content or no content.
It's not that. It's either their content or no content.
No, but the way it should be. All right. If I post something somebody finds offensive, don't go back to my posts.
You know what? I find it offensive that you guys smoke pot without me.
Well, I mean, my arm is not that long, my brother.
You're breaking his arm. Twist it. Give it here.
Yeah, out to Ohio. I'll mail you something if you want.
No, that's all right. I think the FBI Dixon. Gets involved when you do that.
Don't worry about it. I got people. I know. Don't worry about it. It's going to come in an unmarked box that says Afghanistan AstroTurf. Trust me.
Yeah, know what it's going to be with dog shit with pot in it.
Mm.
And you're going to have to separate the pot from the dog shit.
Yeah.
I'm not talking this plastic
if,
yet.
If it comes marked Bolivian baby powder, wrong package, return to sender.
Wow. These people are ridiculous. You get all these fucking fake Facebook requests of these hot chicks. You go to their page, see if you know who they are, or even to look at their pictures, whatever the case may be, and then you find out their account has existed for 37 minutes.
Yeah, it's Al-Qaeda.
Right.
Al-Qaeda, man, they're recruiting.
Apparently.
I never get... As soon as I see a picture of a hot chick that I don't know... Right. It's like, fuck Christ.
Well, that's what I don't get. Why is Facebook censoring people like us, deleting accounts from people like us, but they don't censor that shit?
Windows 95. It was a year later that when I got chicks calling, saying they were with the pitches and they were the balls and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
It was the same thing. They were from either somewhere in Africa or it was just retarded. I can't believe what people fall for that shit.
You would not be shocked at how many people actually fall for that.
Kamala goes, yeah, I will. I'll save a ticket for you.
You've just gotten $10 million.
I goes, no, you borrow the money. When you get here, I'll pay you back. And none of that ever happened.
No.
Right.
They wanted me to fly him out. I goes, you're full. That ain't happening.
We go back to the censorship shit. They want to censor the right. Censor. Oh my God, that guy's pro Trump. We got to get him out of here. Right.
That's what I say when it's like that. I'm saying they deserve it, but they're playing against it. They're making it. It's not just one person doing and getting away with it. It's fucking thousands.
It's like my buddy. I'm not going to say his name. He gets a thing from the fucker. He gets a phone call from the IRS. You owe this, blah, blah, blah. We need you fucking, you got to send us a payment now. My buddy Tim's like, are you, I just said his name. I didn't say his last name. Anyways, he's like, you would not be calling me. You'd be sending me a letter, like a physical letter.
Right.
It came in my fucking mailbox, snail mail. That's how the IRS does shit. They do it the old-fashioned way.
Yeah, especially when it comes to your refund.
Yeah, especially in California. They've been waiting for their fucking state refunds for like 6 years.
Yeah, that's bullshit. You could take two people and they could say the same identical sentence, same identical words... But one will be a liberal, one will be a conservative, and the liberal will be, oh my God, you racist, mm-hmm. homophobic pig.
That's what they all fall back on.
Well, that's like...
If we didn't say it, it's wrong. If it wasn't our idea, it's wrong.
The more they say it, the more people don't believe it.
Yeah.
That's the problem. They can advertise all they want.
Well, here's a prime example of that. I'm sorry to cut you off, Jeremy. But here's a prime example of that. Yeah, I am. Fuck off. Jimmy Kimmel, to his credit.
Oh my God!
When first got elected,
you're going to give that son of a bitch credit for something.
He was talking about his. I know. I hate to say it, but you can look it up on YouTube. He was going to people on the streets, talking about Trump's tax cut plan, and saying it was Bernie Sanders or Hillary's or somebody like that.
I think it was Bernie.
And they were all agreeing with it until he said it was Trump's. And one black guy, do you know what? They handed it to this guy. He was great. He's like, well, I got to reevaluate my thought on that. Everyone else was like, well, it sounds good, but I still hate him.
You could do that with any of Trump's policies. If you go out right now and say separating children from their parents at the border was a Clinton idea, they'd be all for it.
Yeah, enforced by Obama.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
For 8 years. 8 years it was enforced.
Created by Clinton, enforced by Obama.
Like I said, this is selective hypocrisy.
Yeah. It's like, hey, we were going to do that, but because you did it, we're going to say it was wrong.
Right.
It's not the policy, it's the person.
Actually, it's not even that they want the Democrats or the left wanted to do any of this shit.
They're not going to buy this.
The Democrats and the left didn't really want to do any of this shit. They just said they were going to, and now because somebody's actually doing it, they're pissed off. Because
right.
He took their ideas, he's ruining it for them.
Look, like Jimmy said this earlier, about separating children from their parents. He goes, go to any
courthouse in the U.S.,
and you will see parents being separated from their children.
Whether it be divorce,
what about our criminals?
What about our men being separated from their families?
I don't have a driver's license.
What about our men and women in the military who have to go overseas or sit out at sea in a submarine or on a ship for 6 months at a time? What about our men and women in the military who die in combat and don't get to come home to their families? Mm-hmm. What about our law enforcement men and women who die in the line of duty and don't get to come home to their fucking families?
Lord Jeremy, that's fucking awesome. You made the best
point
possible.
This is the news media making a big deal out of the illegals again.
Out of people committing crimes.
It's not just the media.
Stories. It ain't.
It's not just the media. It's the
Democrats.
They don't give a fuck about the American people, because with the American people, the Democrats cannot succeed. It's not undocumented immigrants or illegal immigrants anymore. It's what do they call it? Undocumented Democrats.
Right.
It's all about the vote, the power, the money.
Undocumented to begin with, they're illegal aliens.
All right. You know what? I'll I'll reduce this to its lowest common denominator, right? When's the last time you heard a Democrat, right, talking about how things are good and, you know, things are looking up and we got the economy running?
The only time you'll ever hear that
Democrats
in their campaign
was Clinton.
The only time you'll ever hear a Democrat say something like that is when they're in a campaign.
Democrats can only function in chaos.
Oh my God, we need votes, so we must say smart, nice things, and then when we get into office, fuck the American people.
Right.
Yeah, well, they thrive on chaos. Look what Obama did for 8 years. He started race riots on purpose.
Like I said, the race relations haven't been so bad. You know what I mean? Since the 60s.
And do you know what the funny thing is? Go talk to the average black person, right? They don't feel that way. They only show the radical black people. The average black person does not feel the same way as Black Lives Matter.
Right.
Yeah, case in point, Charlottesville, Virginia. Saw what happened with that in the news, how that went, how that looked, how many people got sued, a woman died, and everything else. And mm-hmm. they only showed the radical side of both opposing groups.
Right, left and right.
They didn't show the guys that were out there administering first aid, giving food and water to protesters on both sides, mind you, having, you know, unbiased conversations, you know, conversating with both sides without fighting. They didn't show any of that stuff. They only showed the people who were fucking fighting with each other.
Man. Jeremy, when I was working down in Brooklyn, right, me and my brother, we were talking to these two black guys, Democrats, right? And we're going back and forth. And what a great conversation. Nobody was mean to each other. We both respected each other's side. It's not as bad as everyone thinks. It's not. It's just the media hyping it up.
Yes, exactly. The media hyping it up, indoctrinating people. Well, see, the you got a lot of the media, and I swear to God, I think Fox News does this shit too, but I don't really watch them anymore because of this. But they, like you said, they hype things up, and then they only show one side of the story. CNN, oh my God, Trump's destroying the country. Fox News, oh my God, CNN's lying about Trump.
See how many black people
usually, yeah.
Go on
well,
YouTube.
Well, yes,
right?
I agree with that. But what I'm saying is they don't have a Democrat and a Republican sitting there talking on Fox News. They don't have a Democrat and a Republican sitting there talking on CNN.
They got a few of them.
And but not one on one. Is he saying?
Right. What I'm saying, they don't have these people from one side or the other. It's Republic. If they have a Republican on CNN, it's a Republican who disagrees with Trump.
Yes, right. Yes.
It's never somebody who agrees with him. They will not take a Republican that agrees with Trump and put them up against a Democrat that disagrees with Trump.
Right. No, because he'll win because, every time.
Yes, because there's no valid argument from the left.
Yes,
they're running out of gas. They got nothing to talk about. They don't have a leg to stand on.
That's why Fox is number one. The people have tried Fox and saying, "Oh my God, this is all going on. We didn't know."
When it comes to liberals, it's all about feelings. It's not about facts. It's about how I feel, how I'm offended,
exactly
how what you're saying bothers me.
Well, then they get on there and they tell you, you should be offended by this or you should be offended by that.
Exactly. I'm not. No, I'm not offended.
The decision
takes to offend me?
The decision on what offends me is my decision.
Exactly.
You know, they're trying to tell you what to say, how to think, what to believe. Like I said, the decision on what offends me is my decision. It's not theirs.
Yeah. I'm not going to be spoon-fed your bullshit. I don't want it. I reject it on both sides. And I'm talking about like the radical right too, like the ultra fucking conservative religious left right. I don't like them either.
They're
trying to tell me how to live.
It's this simple. Regardless of what side of the fence you're on, do what we elected you to do or get the fuck out.
We'll leave. Go home. Exactly. You won't
get
be missed.
Get the fuck out.
Yeah.
You represent like us, not your fucking selves. You work for us.
They should give halfway to the person you elected, halfway through his term, they should be
Vote of no confidence.
Yes, a vote of no confidence. You either want him in or you don't.
Yep. I agree with that.
That'll keep him on the
toes. We should be allowed to try the product before it's permanent.
Right.
Exactly. You're on a 6-month trial basis.
Right.
They do it on jobs.
90-day probationary period.
Exactly. Or if Animal House, you're on
no vacation time, no insurance, no nothing until you get your fucking job done. And if you can't do it within 90 days, then you're out and somebody else comes in.
And there's a new person sitting at your desk.
That's what we got to go through at our jobs every day. We go to a new job and we're not performing the way they want us to within 90 days, you're gone.
In
a lot of places
sector,
are like that.
There are prices to be paid. In the public sector, you can do whatever you want. You can be the most incompetent slob, but you got tenure or whatever, and there's nothing they can do. Well, we don't have that authority. you're his boss. Yeah, but I don't have the authority to fire him. But you're his boss. So what do you do?
It's your fucking company. If you can't fire him, why the fuck are you there?
No. In a private company, yeah, they can. I'm saying in the public sector.
Oh, like, you know, publicly like traded VA companies like Facebook, for instance.
No, like the VA, anything that's public funded, taxpayer funded. Cops, firefighters, teachers, fucking politicians. Work for the VA. You can literally watch people die in your waiting room.
Holy crap, a two-minute warning, and we didn't even get to our second subject, but this has been a good show.
I thought it started out slow.
No, it did start out slow, but it's going pretty good. We've talked about a lot of shit that we normally don't talk about on here.
Well, I get a little passionate about it, so.
Well, yeah. We need that passion. That would sell the show for sure if we got that more passionate about it. As long as we don't pull guns out and start shooting at each other.
Well, not at each other.
Right.
You point them away from us. At the gun safety. Bad guys. Yeah, gun safety. Make sure it's pointed at the bad guy.
Right. Yeah, this shoey. All the shit that goes on in this damn country every freaking day, we should have an endless supply of shit to talk about. And we do.
We do, but we don't research it enough because, do you know what?
We're getting down to the end of the minute.
I want to say for the 4th of July coming up, I want to throw a shout out to the troops serving here in the States and abroad. Thank you for your service.
You're welcome.
I would like to give a shout out to not only our troops, but our law enforcement as well, and an extra shout out to our nation's truck drivers.
Yeah, absolutely. They keep
without them,
country running.
They keep the food moving around.
Yes, exactly. Without them, we would not be America.
Yep. Yeah. I wouldn't be able to get a mango in January. I'm serious.
Thanks, Dave. Exactly. Because you drive a truck, we got a mango in January. All right,
we gotta go, folks.
Fuck off, coots.
Peace out, guys.
Take it in. I was angry.